Hey, it's Allison from computers.mom with a quick intro to passkeys. What they are, why you might want to use them, and how to set them up. Let's start with the what and why. Everyone hates passwords. They're tedious to create and manage, they're not very secure, and honestly, people are bad at them. So a group of big tech and financial companies created a better solution called passkeys. With passwords, you have to remember a separate login, that's a username plus a password, for each site or account. A passkey lets you log into any passkey-enabled site simply by unlocking a device you already own. A passkey is a bond of trust you create once between an account you have, like your Visa account, and your device. Once that bond exists, there's nothing to remember. You don't need your username and password to log into the account anymore. You just unlock your device, and the device tells the account, "Hey, I know this person, they're legit," and you're in. Sort of like a high-tech doorman who recognizes you and lets you in. To get started using passkeys, you just need three things. First, you'll need a device that supports them. That can be just about any smartphone, computer, or tablet that is reasonably up to date. You don't need to waste time researching whether or not your device will support passkeys. It's faster to just try it. If it works, great. If not, you've only wasted a few minutes, no harm done. Also, you have to be using some form of authentication to unlock the device. That can be a passcode that you type, or a biometric option like a fingerprint or face recognition, or a pattern lock. You probably have one of those set up already, as you should. If you have no security on your device, you can't use it for passkeys. Finally, the account or site or app in question has to allow passkeys. Google, Apple, Microsoft, Amazon, PayPal, and a rapidly growing list of other companies already support passkeys. Again, no need to do a lot of research. If passkeys are available, you'll usually see a prompt like this to set up a passkey when you log into your account. So passkeys have several big advantages. They're convenient, no more new passwords to invent or keep track of. They're secure because they can't be guessed or reused. And they're private. The passkey is stored on your device. It's not shared with the company. The only downside is that they're new and unfamiliar. But as I'm about to show you, they're pretty quick and easy to set up, and you can try them out with minimal risk. They don't invalidate your old passwords, so you can go back to using passwords if you prefer, but you probably won't want to. Okay, enough theory. Let's take a look at how to set up a passkey and how to use it. Here, for example, I'm trying to sign into a DocuSign account. I click the login button up here, and here we are on a regular login screen that's asking for my email address. Let's zoom in a little bit. I already have an account, so I type in the email address that I normally use to log in and click Next. On this page, DocuSign is offering to let me set up a passkey. Notice that there are three options here. To set up a passkey, I just click Next. If I don't want to do it right now, I click Skip for now and log in to use the old style password login page. If we choose the third option, Not interested, don't ask me again, we won't see this invitation page again. It's a little harder to set up a passkey later on, so be careful. Since we do want to set up a passkey, we click Next. Now I have to prove that I have access to this account. So DocuSign sends me an email with a verification code. I'm sure you've seen those before. Let's pop over to the email and grab the verification code. You can copy and paste or just remember it and retype it. And then click Verify to start the process, which just takes a few seconds. Next, I have to verify my identity on this device. On this particular computer, I use a passcode to log in, so I need to type that in. Once you've verified your access to the account and the device, you'll usually see a confirmation that you have successfully created the passkey. That's it. There's nothing new to remember, and it was very quick and easy. Now, how do we use it? Next time I go to log into DocuSign on this computer, note that the login screen has changed. I can still choose to use the old login with a password, but now I have the option to use my passkey instead. If I select passkey, all I have to do is unlock this device to prove that I'm the right person on the right device. Even if someone were able to steal your passkey, it won't work except on your device. One last point. You may be wondering, what about all the other devices I use? If I set up a passkey on my computer, can I use it on my phone or tablet and vice versa? The answer is that your passkeys can be shared among your devices so long as they're part of the same ecosystem. That is, if you use a Mac and an iPhone or an iPad, or Google Chrome and an Android phone, your passkeys can sync among your devices. That's a topic for a different video. So we've covered the basic setup and use of passkeys. Hope this helps you get started with them and keeps you a little safer online. Thanks for watching. Please click like if you found this helpful, and don't forget to subscribe for more Computers.Mom videos.